Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to USA States Cup 2021. We are live for the first match of the finals bracket weekend. So it's going to be determining the top three teams in the tournament this year over the course of the next few days. Got one match per day for this weekend currently scheduled. We're starting off with the two losers brackets tonight and tomorrow, Massachusetts versus Ohio, followed up by tomorrow's match between South California and North California, El Clasico, as I've taken to calling it. California versus California elimination match. One of the Californians will be going home. Then on Sunday, we'll have our winner's bracket final, Virginia versus Florida, followed up by, depending on who wins, there will be a match somewhere around there between the winners of Massachusetts, Ohio, and the winner of SoCal versus NorCal. We don't know for sure which is going to be which, since it is, of course, determined, by the other two matches. But tonight, we've just got the one. So Massachusetts versus Ohio in a very exciting matchup. Hopefully getting a full strength Massachusetts tonight. They were missing Tyby last weekend. One of their big carries. We'll introduce the rosters here. There we go. Massachusetts, Chili Pair, Tyby, TJ, 7223, Sitho, Will Stetson, and Vector. Hopefully, Tyby attendance will occur tonight, and he will be able to help the team out in what is sure to be a very competitive matchup. On the other side, Ohio, Eric Blaze, Shockenape, Kaneko, Utsuwa, and Taro. We know how strong that team is and how strong that team can be, bolstered by two different USA OWC members in Ariun Kablaze, the discovery probably of the last couple years in the American tournament scene in Utsuwa, who has been an incredibly consistent third player for that team. And of course, they are rounded out with some very good players also. But Massachusetts, man, looked really good in their matches up until dropping in a tiebreaker against Virginia last weekend. Missing Tyby, still taking Virginia to tiebreaker, I think says a lot about how strong that team is and how strong that team is capable of being and what kind of performances we can expect out of them. So hoping for a good one here tonight. We take a look at the bracket. We're coming down to the wire here, just in the last few matches of the tournament. So we are here with the bottom half losers bracket match, top half tomorrow, and then winners bracket to come on Sunday. You can see the team's routes to get here. Massachusetts taking out teams such as Oklahoma, Michigan, and North California. Back-to-back tiebreakers over the past 2 weeks against NorCal and then against Virginia. Meanwhile, Ohio lost on tiebreaker at the hands of the other California team, SoCal, taking them out. But not easily, that one. And they will make their maiden appearance in the loser's bracket this week. We should be getting underway here just momentarily. The teams are assembling in the lobby. So we'll be getting them started with the match here. There's Massachusetts, this year's number 5 seed. Looking to live up to it. Already have guaranteed themselves top 6 by being in this weekend. Ohio, the sixth seed. Last year's third place finishers lost to Virginia in loser's bracket final last year for that third place spot. Virginia, who ended up, of course, taking second behind the overpowered SoCal team of 2020 featuring Igki and Vaxxay. But as it hits midnight UTC, should be able... They lost to SoCal and loser, excuse me. Yeah, they lost in winner's final. I have to cast my mind back a year, and it's just not working out. There's too many tournaments, man. This will be our first visit to this map pool. New week, new map pool, finals pool. It's a very difficult one. We've got a 7.2 star Nomad 1, and the rest of the pool sorted out around that. Everything hitting those highlights, hitting those archetypal slots. Got your Freedom Dive Nomad 2. Got your Camellia Nomad 4. Got your Yokespie Airy hidden. Sakura no Zenya DT1. There's some very hype picks in this pool that I'm very excited to see. But first, we must get the team's warm-ups. So we will head into the first warm-up here shortly from Ohio. So this will get us started off. Yeah, so the schedule is wonky. There's something about Ohio. They just don't like playing weekend matches. If Ohio wins, they'll play the winner of SoCal versus NorCal Monday night. If Massachusetts wins, they'll play the winner of SoCal-NorCal on Sunday, either afternoon or evening, depending on which team wins in SoCal versus NorCal. So that is to say there are three different potential times for the loser's bracket potential match this weekend. It's very exciting and not at all confusing to follow in the slightest. I know. I'm as thrilled as you all are. This is a new background. They didn't have this background on this set last time they used this as a warm-up. That's pretty funny. Count suspended. Well... We are underway with warm-up number one here from Ohio. Just a minute and 15 seconds of Tom Sawyer. Should be pretty fun. You'll love to see some nice warm-ups. And anybody in chat who has seen Massachusetts over the last year or two will know already what their warm-up is going to be, because they only ever pick the same warm-up from, well, one of two warm-ups. You'd have a 50-50 chance, I suppose. But it's a pretty easy guess. This was actually... this was submitted by Castellan. Yeah, okay. They've been running some next-level strats with warm-ups. All right. Well, that was a good warm-up. Very fun to see. And now it's time for everybody's favorite Massachusetts warm-up. It's Gaucho. It's Gaucho. You knew it was going to be Gaucho. Because it could have been Gaucho, and it could have been Racist Coffee. It was a 50-50. Gaucho Cup 2 when? Yo, when is Gaucho Cup 2 gonna be? That was a tournament. So into Gaucho we'll go here for warm-up number two. And I'd like to welcome in everyone viewing for what might be the first time. The OSU main menu is kind to us today. Had some very exciting matches. I mean, like I said, Massachusetts' last two matches both went to tiebreaker, so hoping to see some more of the same. Of course, we go into the longest best of that we'll reach, best of 13, first to 7 tonight. So we don't get a tiebreaker until 6 all. This could be a lengthy one. We could be here for a while. Expect us to be here for a while, in fact. So both these teams have just looked very strong. You know, Ohio last week had Michigan and had New York. So not the caliber of opposition that really tests a team's mettle. You know, the quarterfinals previously was, I think, the more indicative matchup. But it doesn't say as much about their skill cap, because the quarterfinals pool was quite a bit easier than this finals pool 2 weeks later. And they didn't look skill capped then, just kind of got outperformed on the tiebreaker. And last week, they were just against two teams that they were much stronger than, with Michigan and New York. So, very curious to see what Ohio is going to look like now that we're on this very difficult pool and they're against a team that's as strong as Massachusetts this year. Whereas for Massachusetts, I think we have a little bit of a better feel. You know, that match they had last weekend against Virginia, going all the way to 6-5 despite missing tie-by, as I mentioned earlier, says a lot about a team when they're able to put together picks and rosters for maps that end up with that level of competition despite not having their strongest player. So hoping they can get to that level of performance again, because they're absolutely going to need it against a team like Ohio. And it really is going to be, I think, determined by whether or not tie-by is here, because Chillier is very good. TJ is quite good at her skill sets. Similarly, Will and Vector, quite good at their skill sets, but tie-by is kind of that X factor for this team. And he's kind of the only player on the team that I think will be able to put up the kind of scores that you expect to see out of Ariu and Kablaze map in and map out. And so it will be very key for him to be here if Massachusetts want to have a shot at this one. For Ohio, I think they just need to be smart with their picks and bans. They are a very well-rounded team. They have very high skill cap. They have a pool in front of them that is very difficult, that lends itself toward well-rounded teams who can play anything you throw their way. And they have kind of that factor of being able to toss Ariu, Kablaze, and Utsuha at pretty much any map and know that they're going to get a very good score on it. Where a lot of teams don't have quite that level of confidence in whatever their three-player core may be. So we're gonna get into the bans here, and we will find out what wants to be removed from the pool, what we're not gonna be seeing, maybe a little bit of the strategy for these teams will shine through, and then we'll get into the match proper from there. So, it will be first man from Team Ohio, the blue team on the screen, on the right. And they will open up with Hard Rock 3. Ain't nothing like a funky beat. Massachusetts instantly returning fire with Hidden One Dopamine. So that's going to get rid of a couple things. It's going to get rid of a very tricky alt-aim Hard Rock pick for Ohio. It's going to get rid of a very tricky tech hidden pick for Massachusetts. Kind of expecting that sort of thing. Massachusetts, you know, maybe targeting hidden, maybe targeting tech, with the fear of how good Ariu and Kablaze are at those skill sets. Ohio targeting a little bit of Hard Rock. You know what to expect out of players like TJ, so you can kind of, you know, remove her a little bit, kind of take a few of those picks away that Massachusetts may have picked. They did very well in some Hard Rock picks last week against Virginia, a team that's also quite good at Hard Rock. Ohio, interestingly, going to ban double time number one as their second. That's Sakura Nozenya. That's the air 10.3 high star rating, aim-focused double time pick. 267 BPM, almost 4 minutes long. It's the high consistency DT. And Massachusetts goes ahead and bans out Nomad 6, the very awkward KTG-ster version of Koi Gokuro, as their last ban. That is another one where I think Ohio would be quite good, and Massachusetts would not feel quite as strong with that type of map. And now if you're Massachusetts, you probably pick Nomad 2 first, and that's exactly what they're going to do. So it is going to be Freedom Dive, Frenzy's map set of this, the Extreme Diff, coming out as the first pick of the match. 222 BPM streams, you know it, you love it. Everybody's familiar with the classic. This is a little bit of a modern take on the map. No less difficult, but a bit different. Very long, 4 minutes and 21 seconds. Somewhat uncomfortably high BPM for some players. This can be tricky. 222 BPM streams, not everybody's favorite. Quite long. Some diff spikes. A little bit easier to read than the original, of course. Air 9.6, whereas the original top diff is air 9. So, a very expected Massachusetts pick. One of those teams that is known for kind of what we call left-handed maps. Good at things that require a lot of tapping. Speed and streams are their forte. Concern quickly becomes, though, we don't see Tybi in the lobby. It's going to be Sitho in currently to join Chillier and TJ. And I don't know what to make of it, but we'll see. If Tybi is online, this might just be a map that they wanted Sitho in for. Hard to say. We'll see Kablaze, Ariu, and Utsuha over there on the side of Ohio. That's going to be their core roster. We're going to see those three for probably a majority of the picks. A little bit of Taro for maybe like a Nomad 1 or an AIM type of map. Kaneko, Shock, and Ape definitely feature a little bit less in the roster selections for Ohio than do the other four. But all that said, we got to play, guys. Massachusetts, Ohio, map number one, Nomad 2, selected by Massachusetts, best of 13 for a spot in loser's bracket, round 7. Winner of this will await the winner of tomorrow's match, El Clasico, between the California teams. Will it be Massachusetts making top 4? Or will Ohio reprise their role? Try to make it onward into that grand finals weekend 2 years in a row. That is what we are set to find out over the next couple of hours as we get underway with the first couple hundred combo here of Freedom Dive. type of map that people saw in the pool and went, OMG, this is a Virginia map. And then the Rectagon incident happened and it was no longer a Virginia map. Gonna be interesting to see on Sunday whether this one shows up in that winner's final. But very similar in certain aspects to the original. Some somewhat awkward linear aim, lots of streams, some tricky little one-third patterns. You see breaks from Chili Repair and Sitho early on here. That is not optimal, and Sitho's Ak suffering quite badly as well. The Blaze and Eryu both on the FC still, unsurprisingly. Utsuha with their only break, but it was quite early. And so Ohio will have an early 60,000 point lead. And TJ finds a break on the kick slider jumps. That is all of the full combos gone for Massachusetts. Not starting off the way you'd want your first pick to go. I don't know what they necessarily would have expected out of this. Ohio typically pretty strong on Nomad 2s as well. Kablaze will be the first to break for the Ohio side. And we're only halfway through, so there's plenty of time left. But Sitho breaking once again and still has not been able to recover any of his accuracy, so it's not a good look for Massachusetts. Are you dropping a whole bunch of hundreds? It keeps the combo alive. 200k lead now for Ohio. Again, only halfway through, but not what you want to see if you're Massachusetts. All three full combos gone, 240,000 points, nearly the deficit. Ohio gonna run away with this, as they so often do. As long as they can keep their combo up just a bit longer, that lead will become insurmountable in a hurry. And again, the most tricky part of the map, very mechanically demanding, bring long streams. There goes Eryu. They need another break, though, for Massachusetts, because Utsuha's still on that near 1,400 combo. TJ finding another break, as well as Sitho and Kablaze. Chili Repair giving it his all for Massachusetts, but Utsuha matching. And, in fact, exceeding that combo by about 500. And this lead, with just a quarter of the map to go, barring some truly tragic circumstances at the end here for Ohio, this lead is safe. Not the first pick that Massachusetts would have liked. I think we've seen some mixed performances from Sitho, especially kind of on this team as that late round speed and DT player, but not as comfortable in the tournament setting, very inexperienced in tournaments, and the performance unfortunately is kind of reflective of that. Just has not been putting up the scores that Massachusetts needs out of him. Utsuha does find a break at the near end here, but the reset from Chillier and TJ comes in to match. The Blaze on a 600 combo, matching Sitho, identical combo for those two. And this is going to be a blowout break point on pick one of this match. Ohio by almost 500,000 points, dropping some score at the end there due to the misses, but a very convincing 400k plus win. And the 1-0 advantage is theirs. The break point is theirs. The pick advantage now in their favor already, just to start things off. That is a very unfortunate way to start off affairs if you are the Massachusetts team. Not what you want to see by any stretch of the imagination. But fortunately for them, there is a lot of match to come. Best of 13 means we've got a long road ahead of us. We're going to see the immediate Nomad 4 pick here from Ohio. Bleed Blood. This is a map that I actually know Massachusetts was considering banning out and left it up anyway. I think anybody who's familiar with Ohio knows how strong Kablaze and Air you are on these tech maps. But the secret weapon of Massachusetts has arrived. Tybi is an incredible tech player. Have the peak roster for Massachusetts, Chili Repair, TJ, and Tybi all available, looks like, for this map. Presumably going to be Kablaze Eryu, and I would expect Utsuha as the third for Ohio. Typically, that's the roster they run. So we will go in momentarily here. All right, pardon the, oh wait, never mind. Don't pardon anything. Okay. Yeah, if you're lagging or behind or anything, they haven't started. They shouldn't have started. At least not in Turnier Client, unless Bancho is lagging. Anyway. Tech pick, Nomad 4, very long map once again. We have quite a few of those in this pool. This one's 4 minutes and 14 seconds. As to be expected of Mir, a very tricky, difficult map. And Massachusetts struggling mightily with their accuracy in the intro here. But there is so much time, you know. The ACK in the intro is not going to be the end of the world. Chili Repair does find the first early break. We get just a little bit of Bancho lag. Hopefully that will sort itself out. And there we are. Into the first drop. Tybi finds the second break. A little bit interested to see Massachusetts leaving this up, in fact, in place of Nomad 6 with that second ban, but they know better than I what to expect of their scores. However, they've lost all three full combos and have no real combo to speak of. Meanwhile, Eryu and Utsuha both still on FCs. Pretty good spot to be in if you're Ohio already. Utsuha does find the next break. There goes Kablaze as well with the reset, so if Massachusetts had any amount of combo, they'd be in a decent spot to try to bring this back, but Eryu's still FCing and nobody over a 340 combo for Massachusetts, so they've got some ground to make up. They require an Eryu break, and they require their team to do a better job of building combo than they have been so far. Only a third of the way in, already over 100k lead. And this is just a map that Eryu is going to hold his combo for a really long time on. Nobody breaks on a little 1/6 burst. Gotta be careful about that one. Chili Repair does find the next break from Massachusetts. It's gonna be met by a break from Kablaze. Utsuha following up. Man, this situation for Massachusetts is so unfortunate. If they had better combo, considering the multiple double resets for Ohio, but only Tybi and TJ adding up to Eryu's combo combined. And they will see that score for any of them who have leaderboards enabled. 120k the lead for Ohio at the halfway mark of this map. but there is still half the map to go. Nothing is set in stone quite yet. The outcome still to be determined. It's going to require Massachusetts to do some digging here. Really go deep and see what they can do. There's the break that Massachusetts needed. Ariu's full combo is now gone. Tyby and TJ are in the position to bring this gap down if they can hold. Tyby does not. He misses on the spaced burst, and now Kablaze and Utsuha adding up to match TJ's combo. Finally able to build some combo after their couple of double resets. Massachusetts seeming like they might have had a way back in, but Utsuha and Kablaze just saying no to that one. Still in a situation where if they had both broken, TJ could have brought it back a bit, but instead it's TJ breaking and Kablaze Utsuha holding for longer. And a little more Bancho lag, but we are at the point where I don't think this is comebackable. Hello, Bancho? Bancho, please? It's not me. Hello, Bancho? Anybody? There we go. Okay, I wonder if Tyby DC'd or if he just lagged, his client lagged. I'm not actually sure. I think Tyby may have disconnected. With the amount of time left, it wouldn't really matter anyway. There wasn't a chance for Massachusetts to come back in this one. But that is an unfortunate occurrence for Massachusetts. You hate to see it. Oh, maybe he didn't die. All right, we're going to get to see Tyby on his own for a few seconds here while he catches up with everybody else. I don't know if the rest of them finished in the game or not, but we'll get a little Tyby solo action. Yeah, he's actually finished already. Spoilers, Massachusetts does not win the point. Tyby does put up a good ending combo here, though. This is kind of unfortunate. This amount of combo, if only it had a little more support. A good job from Tyby, but unfortunately, not enough. And the pick goes to Ohio for a 2-0, not 3-0 lead. We'll fix that real Yep. Yes, I know. I'm aware. There we go. Somebody fix my client, please. There we go. Sorted that out. Actually didn't sort that out, but now sorted it out. Osu laser client, not even once. And it's going to be the Hard Rock 1 pick for Massachusetts coming in. Bancho lag when they were trying to pick it, so it does seem to be on Osu's end, that lag we were seeing during the map. Massachusetts going into a skill set, again, that is quite favored typically toward their side of things. A Hard Rock 1 team in the utmost. Is, of course, a map that most people will be pretty familiar with, Iochikai Shihime Kazari. It's been around for quite some time, a handsome map set. Probably well known for a classic Kikizi play, Hidden Hard Rock, that has been rank one for a long time. Chillier TJ tie by. As expected, you know, those are the three we're going to see for most of the mechanics types of maps. Might end up getting. Some Will or some Vector in if we see Hidden. We do have Hidden 2, of course, that's the low approach rate Hidden in his world. Area Hidden, the domain of Vector, the domain somewhat of Will Stetson as well. Freemod 2, of course, the air 8, circle size 5 Freemod pick. Another potential. But I don't think you want to go those maps if you're Massachusetts against Ohio. So instead, we're probably going to continue seeing picks somewhat like these. We'll see how this one goes. I mean, maybe. I don't know if you maybe go Hard Rock 2. It's the CS6.5 Hard Rock. If you're Massachusetts, I think you maybe see how Hard Rock 1 goes first. And then you kind of go from there. You see if it works out. Kablaze, Eryu, and Kaneko coming in for his first map for Ohio. Ohio now, of course, playing with house money. 2-0 up. They've got the consolidated breakpoint. All they have to do is win their own pick, so anything beyond that is gravy. But we will expect them to play hard and play well in every map, and look for more breakpoints, try to take this even farther in their advantage, into their favor. Massachusetts just maybe a little off their normal level tonight. Chillier pair having some struggles in this match so far in the first couple picks. As we know, there is a lot of time still remaining in this match. But, you know, you fall behind that early double breakpoint, things get a little questionable, a little iffy for sure. Just the early break from Chillier pair so far. You're not going to see too many misses on this one until the key eyes, though Chillier and Kaneko do match breaks. Helps out Massachusetts' cause just a bit. The advantage just at about 30,000 points. Accuracy in favor of Kablaze and Eryu. Eryu so good at Hard Rock accuracy over the course of this tournament. It's been something that he has really shown on his accuracy on the free mods where he takes Hard Rock for their team has been remarkable time and time again. Kaneko does find another break, so combo advantage does go to Massachusetts. They will be able to take the lead for the first time in this match, really. This is the first lead that they have held, and we are on the third map now. But better late than never. And so we'll see if they can't make that lead grow a bit more as we come toward the halfway mark of this pick. Gotta get that confidence in place, I think, if you're Massachusetts. Of course, you know TJ, typically a relatively emotional-based player, can play very well when things are going well, but if things go badly, they go very badly. So having a good performance on a pick like this that plays into her comfort zone, much like last week against Virginia, where she carried the 6.5 circle size Hard Rock pick, I think would do a lot for that mental and do a lot for her performance going forward in this match. Taibai does under-aim the slider head, though, and that's going to be a slider break for him. That gives the advantage back over to Ohio. Kaneko does continue to have some trouble, but Kablaze and Eryu still on the double full combo. A and they will take this lead back over probably within this Kei, though Kaneko is struggling, and that is helping out Massachusetts a bit. Mass needs a break from either of those two big carries on the Ohio side. Ariu still at 99.2 back. There is the break, though, from him. Highest stack in the lobby, but now he's got the lowest combo in the lobby, and that's going to open up the door wide for Massachusetts going into the last third. Let's see what TJ and Chillier can do. An FC on TJ. Chillier with an 870 going towards 900. Does break, but so does Kaneko. So does Ariu. And now it is TJ versus Kablaze. The only two FCs remaining in the lobby. TJ with a 1% accuracy lead has really recovered well on that front. And Tyby with a 350 near backing combo. Lead goes over 100K for Massachusetts. They're not out of the woods yet. There is still adequate score for Kablaze to make up this gap. But TJ, so comfortable and so confident on these types of picks, looking to bring them into port. Does find a slider break, but so does Kablaze. And the miss goes unpunished from TJ or from Kablaze, depending on how you're looking at it. Tyby with a 540 combo will be enough to maintain this lead for Massachusetts. And into the outro we will go. It is going to be Massachusetts putting their first point on the board in this matchup on their second pick. That one, finally Massachusetts gathering a little bit of comfort. And a good performance from TJ, 867K, best score in the lobby by a sizable margin of 80,000 points. Really well done from TJ there, and solid backing scores from Tyby and from Chillier Pair. Also, a lot of that came down to Kaneko struggling so much, unfortunately. A little bit of third player syndrome there, I think, for Ohio. Maybe Utsuha not as comfortable on that type of map, and so did not end up playing it. And that was a nice 200k gap from Chillier Pair back to Kaneko, and the score gap was 218,000, so, you know, you can kind of put two and two together, do the little bit of math that's required on that one. But that does mean that Massachusetts gets on the board. And it is going to go back over to Ohio for their second pick. Nomad 4 felt like such a no-brainer. We'll see if their second pick works out equally well. They have been a team that has liked Freemod quite a bit. This week's Freemod 3, though, not the kind of Freemod 3 we've seen. It's, you know, Soulwind, much more just a stream map. Whereas a lot of the Freemod 3 picks have been, you know, somewhat aim-focused. So a little less favor to them as a team that's so strong on Freemod picks. They do have Freemod 1 available. That's the aim Freemod, but it's a lower BPM. Massachusetts may be comfortable with it. A lot of options available to Ohio this early in this match. Actually, not many maps taken off the board as of yet, so. And it is going to be the Hidden Three. We get the Hidden Three from Ohio, Mid Origo, Queen Bee. AG, Queen Bee's expert diff, well, you kind of maybe saw this coming as an Ohio pick against this Massachusetts team. 153 BPM, alt and space streams. Not the sort of thing that one typically associates with Massachusetts. They do have some low AR specialists and some hidden specialists, but this map is not the sort that you'd really think of when you think of that team. Will Stetson gonna make his first appearance, presumably Vector as well. TJ7223 hidden. I don't know about that one. I I don't know about that one. But we'll see how it goes. Eric Blaze, Utsuha, the unsurprising trio in on this one for Ohio. Continuing to defend that early break point with their lives. A lot of eyes on Vector on this one, I think. Well known as a hidden specialist. That is his role on this Massachusetts team. That is what he is here for. That is what he does best. And if Massachusetts is going to have a shot on this pick, they're going to need him to do well. And TJ, the wild card. You just don't know with TJ on a hidden pick. There is no way of telling how this might go. Area could play Zutsuwa a little bit more of known quantities, but this map is so tricky to be consistent on. There's a reason it has so few FCs, despite, I mean, it has a relatively low play count as well, but it is not for the faint of heart, especially not with Hidden. Hidden Flow Aim, one of those very tricky skill sets, especially in low BPM like this. Just, you can fall off streams and you just are gone, as we see there. And that is four misses instantly on this first stream. Those patterns overlapping themselves, increasing in spacing, decreasing in spacing. This is a very demanding map, both for your reading and for your tapping and your aim. It just throws everything at you and does not let up. The Blaze, the only one left with a combo. Above 240, 250. We'll see if that was a break. I'm not positive. We're going to watch that combo there and see if it shows back up. We do see some fake misses here and there thanks to the client lag, and it was not a real miss. I suspect it as such. General rule of thumb, if you see a break immediately after a player lags, it's not an actual miss, and their combo will resume itself soon enough. And as to be expected from Ohio, performing quite well in this pick, Kablai is still on her FC, and Ariu with a solid 500 combo after the early miss. Will and TJ having some time there, but not for long. Having some time to shine, but it did not last. And now Kablaze and Ariu can just take off as Massachusetts finds full resets. The micro movements. The micro movements. Too powerful. An FC on this in a match would be pretty remarkable, might I add. Still a decent amount of map left. It transitions a little bit here. We see this slider aim, a little bit of a change in the rhythm expression of the map. But the Blaze showing no signs of letting up, nor is Ariu. And Utsuha, despite only having half the combo of the next best player on the team, outscoring anyone from Massachusetts, so not any concern on that side. They are doubling the score of their opponents. Or near enough. There's a break from Ariu. We may not see the doubled score of Massachusetts on the Ohio side, but we'll see something pretty close to it. Now we just watch Kablaze coming into the last few hundred combo toward the end here. Will she be able to post an FC in the most difficult section? These spaced patterns are so tricky, and Kablaze just hits them like it's nothing. You're not supposed to hit all of this. Both Kablaze and Utsuha, as well as Vector, both will break. Kablaze, though, still going. The aim in this portion of the map is absolutely absurd, and she is just playing this like it's the easiest thing. This could be two stars. Finally, a chain miss at the very end. Kablaze showing she's mortal, but only for a brief second. And Ohio easily takes their pick. It's going to be a million-point win. And Kablaze with a 900K. You are simply not supposed to do that. Ariu, by the way, 99.2 accuracy. You're not supposed to do that either. This is Ohio on all cylinders. Kablaze with the near 1v3, and that is kind of how that map is going to go, but you're still not supposed to put up a score like that. It's just not right. Meanwhile, Eryu, man, only 639k because of where his break was, but that accuracy is absurdly good. You do not see Ak like that on a map like this very frequently. And even Utsuha, a distant third for Ohio, still 100k better than the best score on Massachusetts. I mean, it was a no-win situation, I think, for Massachusetts. They were in a tough spot for bans in this match. It was always going to be a position of ban what you can and hope you win all your own picks, because you're going to leave something up that Ohio's favored on. But I don't think anybody expected a victory quite that one-sided on any of these picks. So 3-1 goes the score. Play some of the longest maps in the pool. We actually just went 4 minutes 21 seconds into 4 minutes 14 seconds into 4 minutes 10 seconds into 4 minutes 12 seconds. Just picked the four longest maps in the pool back to back to back to back. Oh man, 45 minutes in, we've played four maps and they're not even doing anything slowly. Hi-Bye and TJ, not what you want to see if you are a Massachusetts supporter. Only a couple hundred combo in, so it's not going to be the end of the world, but not the way you want to start when your own pick is to have zero FCs left before you even hit the 200 combo mark. As Chili Repair falls victim to that break syndrome. Meanwhile, all three from Ohio holding on thus far. Relatively short map because of the amount of breaks and filler time in it. And Ariu brings home the full combo, carries Ohio to a victory. A little bit closer than it looks without the FC from Ariu. That one might just be winnable for Massachusetts. But Ariu said, not today, boys and girls, not today. And Ohio takes their second break point for a 4-1 lead. This gets a little questionable now if you're Massachusetts. This is a very tough spot to be in, down 4-1. Really? Theirs, they say. So it's going to be the AR8 hidden pick, his world, Zebrahead version expert diff, mapped by Yokespy. Just 5.48 stars, but don't let that fool you. A very tricky map to read, a very tricky map to aim. As expected of somebody whose skill set is firmly ensconced within reading. Now we're going to see Will Stetson and Vector from Massachusetts alongside Chillier. Problem is, they're going up against Ariu and Kablaz. Coming out to win 10 out of 10. Got a real rough next fight. Something's liberal. This is the sort of thing where you would expect Massachusetts to be able to put up some good scores, but probably not enough good scores. They will need more score than I think is unfortunately all that likely out of the players who are left. We've seen what Ohio is capable of on maps like these in the past. Kablay is a supreme low approach rate hidden player. Utsuha and Eryu, no slouches either. If anyone was needed to be called upon to match Vector on a late round low AR hidden, it was going to be Kablaze. Among that company, maybe not quite at the level of, say, Utami, who is, for my money, the best low AR gimmick player in the country right now. But definitely up there, especially among full-time tournament players. So we'll see what those denizens of this niche skill set can show us on this pick. Ohio looking to consolidate a second breakpoint, which would give them a 5-1 lead, a commanding lead. Massachusetts, as I said, really have not looked like they can do anything to make inroads on Ohio's picks. But will this map break that trend? Will Stetson with an earlier break. You can already see the difficulty of this map represented just in these earlier patterns. Some perfect stacks. Some awkward aim reminiscent of something like a Delis or a Mirage. Even Isomir D'Angelo. That kind of aim is what you're going to be seeing over the course of this pick. Those overlapping sliders making things just that little bit more difficult even still. Eryu and Will, though, so far the only two to break, so it's basically a tale of two maps. You've got a 2v2 until that break from Chillier. You had a 2v2 between Vector and Chillier pair, Kablaze and Utsuha. Will versus Eryu, but Will Stetson and Chillier pair both finding breaks out of the first chorus, and Vector the only one left to the surprise of absolutely no one. Ohio still rocking the double FC. Kablaze and Utsuha clean, 99.67 accuracy FCs on both. Utsuha does find a break. It's the start of the climb back for Massachusetts, but they've got a long way to go. They got to hold some combo and hope for Eryu or Kablaze to find a miss as well. Neither of which seem to be in any danger. And Vector, instead, it's going to be Vector with the miss. Massachusetts now has no full combo. They have one combo over 100. Eryu and Kablaze is still doing quite well for themselves. Kablaze is still on the FC. Eryu with the high accuracy, one break only. Past the halfway mark, it is a 200,000 point lead for Ohio. They will be loath to relinquish it. Ohio showing their skill set, showing why they are favored in this tournament. They are one of those teams that have been discussed as ones that can win the entire time. And it is performances like this that make you really understand why. Kablaze does find the late break, but damage has long since been done. 500,000 points to lead for Ohio. That 4-1 lead looking like it's going to be a 5-1 lead here shortly. All that's left now is to see what kind of score they can put up here once we get through this ending. Eryu making it look easy. Utsuha making it look easy. Vector, the unfortunate victim of an ill-timed break. But no matter what, the outcome was really never in doubt. It's a 700,000 point, 800,000 point win there for Ohio. And that is the double break point. Both have been consolidated. 5-1 is the score, and Massachusetts in a spot of bother now. Ohio 2 points from the victory. And what can they possibly do if they're if you're Massachusetts? Oh boy. Come on, client, work with me here. And it is the double time two pick coming out from Massachusetts. That is their strategy. I don't know how I feel about this strategy, but that is their strategy. I'm sorry about your sorry for your ears to everybody. I have to listen to it too. I don't like it any more than you. Trust me on that one. Knight of Feifan, brother. Met by Landwings. Gives you an idea just how old this one is. 251 BPM. This is the speed double time pick. For all those who love to tap quite fast, you have a great left hand. This one is for you. Standard roster for Ohio. Harry Kaboy Zutsua. Massachusetts going to run with TJ and Chili Repair. They're going to be joined by Sitho. Haven't seen him in quite some time, but expected. DC player on the team. Can he be the salvation that they seem to so desperately need at this point in this match? Massachusetts on their knees, the Osu gods for a comeback of epic proportion. A long way to go if they want to climb back into this match. They seem resolute. One of the shortest maps in the pool, this one, just a minute 35. How will everyone feel? Not great, as Sitho and TJ both break within the first 200 combo. This is the concern I had with Sitho, unfortunately. Performance just not up to stuff. Meanwhile, the three-way still alive for Ohio through the first 200 combo. The first to break is Kablaze. They've got a cushion. Still have the lead in combo, still have the lead in score. Are you having a bit of a rough time? Does find a break as well, looks like. We're gonna see which breaks of those were actually real, because it looks like we may have just seen a basically full combo reset. Looks like they were all actual breaks. So Sitho with a 240 combo matching Kablaze. Arianutsu, a similar combo to Chili Repair and TJ. Accuracy a bit questionable for many players. So 97.69 for Kablaze leads the way. Through the stream, Kablaze falls off. Sitho held through. And Sitho and TJ on sufficient combo to look to bring this one back, especially with Ryu Chain missing. Utsua the only combo for Ohio. The lead's going to go over to Massachusetts. And Sitho looks to be what Massachusetts needed. The 544K. Chillier with the 480K or so just behind. And it is an 8,000 point lead. Once all is said and done, the closest map of this match by far. Sitho makes it happen. 637k S rank from Utsua. Unfortunately, just not enough for Ohio. Massachusetts are able to get their second point on the board. Go now to the next pick from Ohio. We thought it may have been a match point pick here, but Massachusetts managed to pull it out. And now, strange program, Fremont 2. think we kind of expected this to happen. There was always a very good chance that this was going to be a pick for Ohio. Three minutes and 33 seconds, CS5 AR8, 5.32 stars Nomad, 6.2 stars Hard Rock. For those of you who may not be as familiar, free modification picks in this tournament require two players with unique mods. Easy is allowed, but does not count as unique. So if you have easy, you either need to run easy hidden or something along those lines, or you need to have hidden and Hard Rock on the other two. And these are two teams who have players who can run easy, Vector and Utsuha, capable. Is this the Vector easy hidden moment? You could see it happen. Vector easy hidden, TJ Hard Rock, and their third on a preference mod. With Ohio running Eryu Hard Rock, Kablaze, maybe hidden, and Utsuha easy. There is a world where that could be what we get. It'll, of course, be a moment. And all players are present in the lobby, so let's see. What will the modifications be? Will Stetson in as well? So maybe this is Vector easy, Will hidden, TJ Hard Rock. Eryu, Hard Rock, Kablaze, hidden, Utsuha, easy? Well, here we go. Chili Chef. MP start command is done. Let's see. It is easy on Utsuha, easy hidden on Vector. Easy on Hard Rock as well as Eryu. Will Stetson, no mod. Which will leave Kablaze on hidden for sure now. Although Kablaze not connecting. There we are. So easy scores are doubled, but they do match on either side. So the score will basically be accurate, representing the actual score. Don't really need to do any math on this one since each team has an easy player. This one just harkens back to a bygone era. The style of mapping. Characteristic of a time long gone by in OSU history. But one with which these players are very familiar as frequent tournament participants. I is gonna, I think, largely be on these easy players, but just dead even so far. Massachusetts capable of doing well on these free mod picks such as this one. There are some tricky aim patterns for the others. Of course, the buzz slider spam near the end. But still, just matching FCs across the board. Slight accuracy lead to Ohio, but only 10,000 points. Really meaningless until a break occurs somewhere. Nearly halfway through. The longest we've gone on any map without a single break, I believe. 540 plus combo on everyone. It's going to be Kablaze, the first to break, so advantage goes to Massachusetts. That's a terrible place to break, because that does cap her score, but Will Stetson finds a break immediately thereafter, and that is, if anything, worse for Massachusetts than for Ohio. Will Stetson on Nomad versus Kablaze on Hidden. We'll have the score advantage now on Kablaze. Suppose you can go the opposite direction and say it's worse. If Ohio did not have the overmod. But there's a break from TJ. That's a slider break. Still have Vector on the SS. We have Utsuha just dropping, I believe, one or two 100s. Eryu still FCing. Kyle will take the lead back after the spinner. Ariu really has been showing off on Hard Rock in this tournament. He has played so well. His precision aim just on point. Gonna see two different CS 6.5 maps in this match at this rate. Vector, easy hidden SS, still alive. Utsuwa, easy FC, still alive. But it is Ariu that is making the difference as the Hard Rock FC at nearly 99 ACK. We're gonna come into that ending, and Ohio's gonna take this one. Ariu breaks on nothing and drops a bunch of accuracy. That's unfortunate. And into this buzz slider spam we go. Let's see how the easy players do on it. They're the only ones who will hit this. No, Utsuwa does find a break. Wait a minute. Will is comboing and Vector is comboing too. Oh man, that's really pretty close. That's really pretty close, man. Oh, 150K? 140K? That score came down like a surprising amount. Vector with the easy hidden SS. Oh, you hate to see it. You hate to see it because it doesn't matter. But that is such a cool score. Easy hidden SS. Man, you don't see that every day. The strategy worked, but unfortunately, Ohio is the better backing scorers. And they take the point. Very sad for Vector, as his efforts are for naught. Sorry about your ears. And now it will go back to Massachusetts. There are no Hard Rock picks left. Our options get a little limited here. This will need to be the beginning of a massive comeback for Massachusetts. A team that has not come close to a break point. 5-2 down. So they're going to need to win their own pick. Breakpoint. Another pick of their own. We're going to go Nomad 5. Now, Massachusetts, of course, often a team that does well on Nomad 5 picks, as evidenced in previous weeks, but it's a bit of a different Nomad 5. Tricky aim in this one. Not an easy map by any stretch of the imagination, but it's not just the raw left hand, it's not just raw tapping speed. Fair amount of aim, as I said. So things just get tricky in a different way than from a lot of Nomad 5s that we've seen in the past, where they may require more raw tapping ability. This is perhaps the last map of this match We've got Chillier, TJ, and Sitho. No tie by. Against Eryu, Shotgun Ape, and Kablaze. Every map now is do or die for Massachusetts. Match point down. Six to two. That would probably be why my math has been weird this whole time. Chillier and Sitho find an early break, but it's right at the beginning. Not gonna be the end of the world. Eryu finds an early break as well, but Shotgun Ape and Kablaze still on the FCs. TJ, the lone full combo still alive for Massachusetts. Sitho not far behind, and the score gap is going to stay quite close for the moment. Another one of the relatively lengthy picks in this pool. This one just under 4 minutes. Massachusetts are desperately hoping that those aren't the last 4 minutes of their time in USC 2021. Break from Sitho, though, does come out. That hands quite a big lead to Ohio until Shotgun Ape finds a break as well. So it's now Kablaze and TJ on the matching full combos. Chillier not that far behind Eryu. And there goes Kablaze! This combo lead in Massachusetts' hands, but thrown back away as TJ breaks as well. And Sitho continues to struggle, not able to build up a lot of combo, but Eryu finds the break for Ohio. What can Chillier pair do? 500 combo, the largest in the lobby by 300 or so. Trying to scrape away at about a 50k lead. It's going to come down. Question is, can he keep it up long enough for that lead to come all the way down? TJ and Sitho not offering up a lot of help, unfortunately. Currently, very little combo between them right now. Thankfully for Massachusetts' side, Shotgun Ape having his fair share of hardship on this pick. 16k the lead for Ohio. It is coming down. It will go over to Massachusetts if Chillier pair can hold on for just a bit longer. That 730 combo doing all the work that Massachusetts needs. But how long can it last? And how well can Kablaze and Eryu mount a comeback in the second half of the map? The aim quite tricky. Those bursts don't give up. This guitar solo has its difficulty to it. But Chillier is up to the task. Makes it through and into this aim section. He is holding on for dear life. Does finally find a break. It is traded with Kablaze and Shotgun Ape. And this time, Sitho and TJ are right there to have his back. Eryu at a 540 combo, but Sitho just behind as TJ finally finds a break. It is so close still. 16k, 15k, and dropping. The overall combo is in the favor of Ohio. The accuracy likewise. And Eryu putting on the performance that he needs to drag this back over to their side. TJ having trouble in this ending. Chillier and Sitho need to hold on for everything they've got. Eryu, Kablaze, and Shotgun Ape all with a decent amount of combo coming into the last moments of the map. It is about a 40k lead for Ohio, which may just be enough. It is not over yet, but it's going that way, and there goes the break from Sitho. That may just do it. That is going to spell disaster and doom for Massachusetts. As Eryu, Kablaze, and a late break from Shotgun Ape, but all managing to put together combo at the most important time of this map. They take it over, and they take the win up by 100,000 points. And with that, Ohio are your victors by the final score of 7-2 here in the loser's bracket, round 7. GG, well played to them. They will go on to play Monday night. It's going to be midnight UTC, 8 p.m. Eastern time. For that next match, they will await the winner of SoCal versus NorCal. Maybe a rematch for Ohio against SoCal. We'll be waiting for them. We'll see. Well done, though. The skill cap from Ohio in this match, just higher than their opponents in Massachusetts by enough. And they take it in clean fashion. Very, very well done to them. What more can you say? Eryu, Kablaze, just so strong. And Uzuha coming in at key moments. making his presence felt. And that's going to do it for the match. So, let's take a look here at the bracket. Sets up Ohio in that next round of losers. Losers bracket round 7. Ohio will wait for SoCal versus NorCal. That one tomorrow, 19 UTC, 7 p.m. UTC, 3 p.m. Eastern, noon Pacific time. You'll want to follow the stream because that's not one you're going to want to miss. And then Sunday, 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific, Virginia versus Florida in the winner's bracket final. This is the place to be, you guys. We're coming down to the last few matches of the tournament for the year. You'll definitely want to be sure you're following along with the stream for those because they will be epic matches, to be sure. That is going to do it for us for tonight, our one Friday night match, Ohio taking the victory over Massachusetts. Just a few notes for you all. Those matches, as we said, tomorrow, Sunday, and Monday. Three more matches remaining, one a day for the next 3 days. Follow the stream, join the Discord, and be sure as well to check out the YouTube channel. Get the VODs up following these matches. We put up the VODs pretty promptly, so you can definitely check out those. Make sure to subscribe to that. It gets a lot of tournament VODs uploaded. And make sure to check out our friendly sponsor, HyperX, makers of some of the best keyboards in the business, because they have been kind enough to sponsor the tournament, provide prizes for the top teams. I'm going to give back to them. Otherwise, thank you all for being here. I appreciate each and every one of the viewers who tuned in for the match. Congratulations again to Ohio. Massachusetts, unfortunately eliminated. 5th, 6th will be their spot this year. But we'll be seeing Ohio again on Monday night. We'll be seeing the teams that they'll be facing the winner of tomorrow. So be back here in about just under 15 hours' time for that next match, SoCal versus NorCal. Until then, I've been this one guy. We've been USA States Cup 2021. Thank you for watching, and have a great night.